mods.
What's up, you guys? Mr. Sark here. I'm in Germany at Gamescom. I'm playing Modern Warfare 3. No big deal. All right, so I'm joined here by Mike, one of the co-founders of Sledgehammer Games. How you doing, dude?
I'm good. What do you mean, no big deal?
Yeah, no big deal. No, I'm just showing off.
It's a pretty big deal for me.
No, it's just... Yeah, I'm trying to downplay it because I want to be cool in front of my people. Okay. Yeah, so no big deal. Whatever. Modern Warfare 3, that's what I do. But you just gave us the chance to run through the Spec-Ops sampler, if you will. We got two little nibbles. One of them was a mission. One of them was a survival mode. Tell me more about this IED mission that we ran.
Mission modes, as a core component of Spec-Ops, you remember from Modern Warfare 2, comes back in a whole new way, bigger and better. So you played Invisible Threat today, which was a mission that takes place in Berlin, timely for GamesCon, right? And the great thing about these modes now is you get a chance to be really innovative in a co-op experience, right? So what you played was one player acting as sort of the juggernaut slash hurt locker bomb diffuser.
That was me, by the way. I was the juggernaut. Nice. My camera guy was my cover.
Nice. How do you do?
It didn't go so well. Oh, it didn't go. It was all right. I give him a C-.
Well, it's all about practice, right? But he's sitting on the rooftops, performing sort of an overwatch as a sniper, covering you and directing you to the ID. So really innovative, really cool too, right, that the new XP system that you saw where it ranks up and allows you to open new missions and unlock new weapons, so it ties into the whole sort of Spec Ops mode that we're bringing back.
Now that's totally independent from your multiplayer rank, right? So I can't go like 60th prestige just by playing survival mode with my mom.
It's true. There are different XP systems, and but there's a lot of value in actually ranking up through Spec Ops. It's a ton of fun, as you know, but you also get the chance to open up new weapons, unlock perks, get to experience the armories, and that all leads to sort of making you a better multiplayer player when the time comes to jump in line there. So,
which leads us to the second thing we played. We did a little survival mode, and that's where we really saw the armories kind of popping out, because obviously this is the first time we played it. We didn't get too deep into that. Tell us about where that can go. Like, what are some of the stuff we can unlock? Because I unlocked like a red dot or something like that. But I saw some rather expensive items at the bottom of the lists.
Yeah, that's right. So there are three different armory types throughout Spec Ops Survival. This allows you to do all kinds of customizations to your weapons. There's an airstrike armory that allows you to bring in riot shield guys to support you, or Delta allows you to do perks that you can unlock and have airdrops in, as well as various armor types along the way. You can pick up grenade launchers, all kinds of sort of defense mechanisms. So together, the three kind of allow you to continue that wave after wave survival mode in unique and interesting ways. And as you probably saw, you know, you have a chance to customize your weapons along the way as you get further into it.
How much of this stuff are we going to see in multiplayer? Just lay it on me.
Just lay it on you. I'm going to tell you all right now. It's all about COD XP. COD XP is going to be the biggest multiplayer reveal of the summer. So if you want multiplayer, tune in for COD XP. It's going to be awesome. We've got a ton to share. Just got to wait a couple more weeks.
These guys are going to be blowing out multiplayer at COD XP. Obviously, I was just kind of giving them shit because they tease us. You guys tease us with this cooperative play, and it's like all everyone is like fishing for is multiplayer details, and you just...
I don't know.
You guys are dicks, is basically...
Well, you know, we do our best. I got to tell you, though, I love the Spec Ops modes, right? I mean, I'm a hardcore player of MP2, and we play a lot of time on it, but I think for fans coming back to Modern Warfare, having a chance to play Survival and really getting in deep there, I mean, it's a big game. There's a lot to offer. So everyone's excited about MP, but Spec Ops is fantastic, and I think there's going to be a lot to offer.
Yeah, and speaking along those lines, I know you guys are aware, and obviously you guys are aware, we got a lot of directors that submit videos through Machinima, and I can, just off the top of my head, I can think of a dozen that are gonna just get in and molest the cooperative modes. Like, Spec Ops will be where they live. Talixian, top of the list. I'm looking at you, man. Time trials. Yeah, you know, I'd take you over Brendan, my camera guy, but barely, just barely. Don't give me Sour Patch looks. Whatever, he did all right. But the game's looking great. You guys rock. Obviously, we're gonna see you in a couple weeks at COD XP, but thanks for walking us through this, man.
Yeah, you're very welcome. Thanks to all the fans. We're looking forward to November 8th. Bringing it live.
Oh my god. It's going to be so hot. We'll see you guys there. What's up, you guys? Mr. Sark here. I'm standing here with Noah, product director over at Beachhead. He just gave me a little rundown of COD XP. But before we get to that, you have the best gamer tag of all time. Noah. N-O-A-H. Now you all know it and you can spam him further. He was just complaining. Awesome. I probably shouldn't have said that on, but you know, whatever. It's like, yeah. He got it because he worked at Xbox Live, so he gets like a four-letter gamer tag. Are you kidding? I thought Mr. Sark was short, but anyway. COD Elite, we were just taking a look at it. You were breaking down some of the features. I know a lot of people are still hazy.
Yeah.
Because, you know, there is a subscription element. People are like, what am I going to get? What am I not going to get? The stuff you just showed me was absolutely pimp. And before we begin, by the way, we're going to really be blowing this out at COD XP. But break down for me, in a nutshell, what we just saw in this presentation. Because you went flew through it.
Totally. So what we did is we went through all of Call of Duty Elite. And we kind of focused on Black Ops and what's going on with the beta right now. And then how we're going to be expanding it for Modern Warfare 3. So the key pillars of Elite are Career, Connect, Compete, and Improve. And Career is about like access to your stats, and we're going to grow that and give you even more tools with Modern Warfare 3. Improve is like the guide to multiplayer, how do you get better. Where we're really excited though is Connect and Compete. So Connect, groups, getting into groups with other users, you know, building that group up to a million members and unlocking stuff for all the members of the group. And the big thing for MW3 is clans. So you can have your clan, you have up to 100 members. You can have the clan list right there in the game. You can join those guys. You can compete for who's the best clan. And clans have a level. So you can level your clan up. If you max out your clan's level, you unlock a weekend of double XP for everyone in the clan. So we want to make that serious. And we want to say, if you're willing to commit and work as a team, you know, you can be the best and you can be recognized as the best.
All right, so one of my favorite things that you were going over was the fact that this is so heavily integrated with Modern Warfare 3. You hit on three or four different areas where you could unlock, you know, badges,
yep,
medals. Even in the lobbies, you were saying you can identify like groups that you share with people in the lobby. So I think that's my favorite thing that you guys are doing right now is, it's almost like a co-production.
No, we want to kind of break open the Call of Duty world and let more people in. And so I'll run through those bullets really quick. You know, for groups, if you and I are both a member of, you know, Red Sox, Yankees, you know, we like a beer brand. We're in Germany, Kölsch, right?
Yum, Kölsch. Yeah.
We can see, like, that we have that in common. And what's really cool is we're in a lobby, and you guys have been in lobbies before. No one talks with each other. And now I can be like, oh, man, I love that beer, too. Like, let's play some more Call of Duty together. And that's new. Clans right there in the game. You know, the way we make features for Elite is, you know, either we come up with something, Infinity Ward comes up with something, but if both teams get passionate about it, it happens. And clans is something that both teams are super passionate about. Other things. You're going to be able to push your loadouts right into the game from your mobile phone, from the website. You can copy and share loadouts with friends and kind of turn loadouts into a much more social thing, which is really exciting.
It's kind of hard to break down if you don't have a PowerPoint presentation like right in front of you, but where would you, you know, draw the line for our viewers right here on the subscribed and the unsubscribed, the pay and the non-pay?
Totally. So we're going to do a big breakdown at COD XP next week. But the basics are everything you get in the game is free. You know, it's like if you're looking at your stats are going to be free. But beyond that, other features that are important for free users, we try and open up for everyone. For instance, groups are free. It'd be no fun to be in a group if you can't get in a group. Clans are free and paid. So you can be in the same clan with your free guys, with your premium guys. It's just the premium guys are going to get some more competitions they can compete in. They can contribute to the clan leveling up a little bit heavier. So basically, wherever we can, the premium level is about adding kind of a plus-plus. And of course, you're going to get all the DLC content. So next week, we're going to do that whole breakdown. We're going to announce the pricing. And I think it'll be a slam dunk. Like, if you love Call of Duty, it's easy. And if you want to go free for a while, we got a lot for you.
And you don't necessarily have to be friends with somebody to compare in detail your stats with them. So all you guys can type in C-Nanners now and just see how well you stack up against the Nanner Man. Probably not too well.
We did a little Mr. Sark off today. He beat me. Just by a little bit, but he beat me.
Just barely. Did you like all my Olympia setups?
It was very nice. I told him he was lucky it wasn't Noob Tubes. That's the embarrassing one.
Oh, man, I don't roll like that. I don't roll Noob Tube, all right? Olympia. Bro Olympia for life. All right, you rock.
Sir. It's looking great. Obviously, all of us are going to see you at CoD XP, you know, shortly.
It's going to be epic, man.
It's going to be amazing. And it's looking good. Thanks for showing it off.
Excellent. Thank you so much.